Hello, everybody, and welcome to Inside Georgia Football with Head Coach Mark Rick. Dogs on a bye week and a well-earned one, and it couldn't come at a better time. Gives the Dogs an opportunity to let some wounds heal as they get set to return to SEC Eastern Division play. That'll be next Saturday down in Jacksonville, the annual border bash with those hated Florida Gators. That'll be next week. This week, though, an opportunity to sit back, rest, and relax. And for you, a special show as we're going to sit down with one of the iconic men, not only of the University of Georgia and college football in general, but actually for all college athletics, because Vince Dooley took over the University of Georgia football program 50 years ago. The changes he's seen in the last half century, he tells to our Kevin Kopp. That's all straight ahead on Inside Georgia Football with Head Coach Mark Richt.
Inside Georgia Football with Head Coach Mark Richt is presented by Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future, own it. Also brought to you by AT&T, building you a better network.
There are certain times in life when things get crazy, like when we have great expectations, when it's time to move on, or when life just happens. And when things change and I need a loan, I head to Georgia's Own Credit Union.
Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future. Own it.
So right now, if you get the 15 gig plan, we'll double the data and make it 30 gigs for the same price.
30 gigs? Wow, that's a lot. You don't have to do that for me.
Oh, that's okay.
No, seriously, I wouldn't want you to get in trouble.
It's the same plan for everyone. Families, businesses, whoever.
Right. No celebrity treatment here.
Really isn't any celebrity treatment.
Just a normal guy getting a great deal.
We're just saying it loudly for some reason.
Now get 30 gigs of data to share with family or your business for a limited time starting at $160 a month.
Fans use signs to identify themselves. The chop. The fork. The O. Hook 'em horns. But there's one sign everyone wants to be identified with. Number one. Fans show their loyalty in all kinds of ways. Ours just buy another Hyundai. Number one in customer loyalty 5 years in a row. Show your loyalty using the hashtag ThisIsLoyalty.
I know they inspire their players.
Georgia has the win over 18th ranked LSU.
I'll try to improve from last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
This segment of Inside Georgia Football is brought to you by AT&T, building you a better network.
Well, what an honor it is to get to sit here next to the legendary Coach Vince Dooley to celebrate 50 years since your hiring as head football coach at the University of Georgia, a long association with this university. And is it hard to believe when you throw out a number like 50 years since being hired as head coach? Does it feel like a long time ago, or does it feel like a short 50 years?
In many ways, very short, in some ways long. It's amazing how time flies. I remember that Barbara and I were married 1 year, and we went to her parents' 25th wedding anniversary. And I remember whispering to Barbara, can you imagine being married 25 years? We are now celebrating our 54th, going on 55 soon. So it's hard to believe that it's been 50 years when I came to Georgia. I might add to the shock of a lot of people.
Well, we're going to take a trip through memory lane today and visit some of your old haunts. Some of them have probably changed a fair bit since 1964. As you look at the landscape of college athletics as a whole, and particularly here at the University of Georgia, what's the biggest difference between 2014 and 50 years ago in 1964?
Well, just here in Georgia or in Athens, the university is an example. Our budget, I think, when I came was almost $2 million. When I left, it was over 60 million. Now it's almost 100 million. The stadium was just about 40,000. When I left, it was 93,000. When I came, the annual fundraising was 75,000. When I left, it was 22 million. So you can see that in a period, and that was 40 years, it's been 10 years since then. Yeah, there's been a dramatic change in a lot of ways, and facilities is one.
Well, one of them that was not here in 1964, we're sitting in right now, and it happens that these are the gardens named for yourself, and I'm sure that's quite an honor. We're looking just a few hundred yards from your statue down the way, and sitting in the Dooley Gardens, how much does it mean to have this space on campus dedicated to you?
Well, for a long time, we were wondering what we were going to do with this space. In fact, I even was thinking in my mind to have plans to have added parking facilities because we were running low on facilities for parking. So when they decided to have a statue, then somebody suggested a garden, which I got very excited about because gardening has become my golf. I've said many times the great thing about living around a university, if you've got a curiosity about anything, you can satisfy it. And I've always audited classes in history, Civil War history, and so I thought I'd take a course in trees and shrubs, and that led to a book that I wrote on gardening. So I really got into gardening, and what I like about it is that it really beautified the back entrance to this campus.
Well, I think that anyone that's been here is glad that you didn't go the first route with the parking lot. This is just a little prettier than that.
Yeah, much prettier. And there's a great variety of plants here. And a lot of the students will come, and a lot of people I'll see that will come and walk through the garden, sit down as what I call the contemplative garden over here on the side, which is where there's a lot of weeping plants and a nice place to sit down and a beautiful view of the track. So I'm very proud of it.
Having that broader perspective on Georgia athletics, is it meaningful to see such a wide array of facilities named in your honor?
Very much so. Very proud of that. I was football coach for 25 years, and then I was the athletic director for 25 years, and people said, well, you were here 40 years. Mathematicians will quickly tell you that. But I overlapped, and for 10 years, I was able to do both jobs. Which is not highly recommended, but I was fortunate to have what I call good people on both sides of the ball. I had great assistant coaches and I had great assistant administrators, and because of that, we had some of our greatest years at that time that I was doing both jobs. But in order to see the university with a broad athletic program in all sports, and then to provide the facilities for those programs, I'm very honored to have it in my name.
Well, we're going to take a little tour and a little trip down memory lane. We'll visit some of your old haunts, and looking forward to hearing some of the stories from a great 50 years with Coach Vince Dooley.
Coming up next, his memories of Sanford Stadium, his favorite game, and of course that 1980 national title.
So right now, if you get the 15 gig plan, we'll double the data and make it 30 gigs for the same price.
30 gigs? Wow, that's a lie. You don't have to do that for me.
Oh, that's okay.
No, seriously, I wouldn't want you to get in trouble.
It's the same plan for everyone. Families, businesses, whoever.
Right. No celebrity treatment here.
Really isn't any celebrity treatment.
Just a normal guy getting a great deal.
We're just saying it loudly for some reason.
Now get 30 gigs of data to share with family or your business for a limited time starting at $160 a month.
Together, we're a team. And together, we're family. No place gives teams the brands they need at the lowest prices like Academy Sports and Outdoors. Right stuff, low price, every day.
This is the dream, people. You men will... Is that...
Sir, yes, sir! He's a fire-breathing goat, sir!
Goats can't fly planes. Wow. Give it a shot.
Kevin, you okay up there?
You
You could have just asked me what the red button does.
Live out your dreams. Win up to $300,000 playing Keno with the all-new Bullseye.
They inspire their players.
Georgia has to win over 18th ranked LSU.
I'll try to improve from last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
This segment of Inside Georgia Football is brought to you by Georgia Lottery.
Well, Coach, we are here now on hallowed ground, a place where you spent, as you said, 25 years as a head coach. To be here inside Sanford Stadium, 40,000 seats when you arrived, just shy of 93,000 right now where it presently sits, and I'm sure if we came back in 10 or 15 more years, it'd look very different than it does now. What is your earliest memory of being here inside Sanford Stadium?
Well, the earliest memory that comes to mind is the fact we had lights out here. We had poles that stuck up right by where the players sat on the sidelines. When I was at another school and we would get films from Georgia, you would see the light poles in the film, so you had to kind of look around in order to find what was going on. So the first spring practice we had those lights, which actually you couldn't see very well with them, but we used them that first spring, took them out, moved them over to the practice field where we used them, and then eventually in 1980, 81, 82, early 80, we put permanent lights in, and this is what we have today.
Every week that there's a home game, we see on the video board the shot of you being carried on the shoulders of your team, winning the national championship in 1980. How special does that year feel to you now? I know we're 34 years removed from it, but when you start to think back about that magical season, what jumps to mind?
Well, I think it's what you really strive for, to have that year where there's no question you're undefeated, you're undisputed, you're the national champions. Nobody disputed that. So we were consensus without a doubt and were able to win every football game. And it was, that's what you play for. Now there were other times that we might have had teams that you could put on paper that said it might be better than this 80 team. But the fact remains that 80 teams somehow, some way, won them all. And because of that, they are the national champions, and they'll hold that special pride all their lives.
Well, one of the things as we stand here now and look at Sanford Stadium in 2014, I know you had the chance to attend the Clemson game, which is another one of those great Georgia wins between the hedges. What's the biggest difference in terms of the atmosphere or in terms of game day here in Sanford Stadium right now compared to what it was like 50 years ago when you got here?
Well, just the numbers itself, if you can imagine over twice the numbers of what that means. We had a great crowd though. When we first came, we had some spirited people because all the fraternity freshmen, they had to come here about 3 hours, 4 hours before the game, and they had to sit up in this little section over here saving the seats for their older brothers who came later on. So when we arrived, we had a good crowd. And then we had the track people, which was before we closed in the stadium. And when we played Alabama in 76, there were 10,000 people on that track, and they were packed at 7 o'clock Friday night before the game the next day. So those were special moments. But as you see, we kept adding to the stadium. And what I like about the stadium, every addition was in conformity and harmony with the rest of the stadium. So I don't think there is a stadium in the country or the world that has a stadium in which every seat you can see what's going on. It is the best view of stadiums in the country, and we're very proud of it.
There are so many games that you have coached here, so many games that you were witness to as athletic director, and now the chance to be a fan. If you had to pick a favorite memory at Sanford Stadium, what would it be?
Well, I guess it was the first and the last, because you started with a win. We had our first win against Clemson, I believe it was, ironically. And I guess the last one was against Georgia Tech, our arch rivals. So there's a lot of things that happen in between, but you never forget the first one, you never forget the last one. Let me also add that, again, it's all about the players, because they're the ones. And what we do is try to get them organized, but their fighting spirit, that Bulldog spirit, is something that always is special, and it's even more special between the hedges.
Straight ahead, we'll hear from Coach Dooley as he talks about his days as athletics director, the changes to Stegman Coliseum, and of course, the statue that now adorns the facilities here at Buttsmere.
There are certain times in life when things get crazy. Like when we have great expectations. When it's time to move on. Or when life just happens. And when things change and I need a loan, I head to Georgia's Own Credit Union.
Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future. Own it.
Year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
Holding down the far sideline, he runs by the last guy. He got a piece of it.
I know they inspire their players.
I'll try to improve from last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
This segment of Inside Georgia Football is brought to you by Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future, own it.
Coach, we're standing here outside of Stegman Coliseum. It's a beautiful, brand new building now in 2014, and I know it was beautiful and brand new in your time, though it probably looks a little bit different now than it may have 50 years ago.
Quite differently. Somebody could write a book on the changes that's been made in this Coliseum. But I came here when it opened because it opened against Georgia Tech in basketball, which was a great crowd. It was overflowing, and we won the ball game, so it was a great way to start. So we were here, the football team was here, our locker rooms were here, and over the years we kept changing and adjusting, and as I say, you could write a book on all the adjustments that have been made, but the latest is great, so we got a beautiful Coliseum.
That it is, and with all the championship banners, Final Four banners that have been hung inside this building, it's a good time to talk about your tenure as athletic director, which, as you said, lasted for 25 years from 1979 until 2004. I think one of the things that we keep coming back to is the success, not just of the Georgia football program during your tenure, but the success of Georgia athletics overall. And how gratifying was that as the AD to witness so many championships during your tenure?
Well, very, very special. And I remember my very first hire was Andy Landers. Andy was, I think, 26 years old, and he used to drop me little cards when he was at Rome Junior College, and I think he had his eye on this job. He knew it was going to be a good one. So he's still here, and what a record he has. So I'm very, very proud of Andy, and of course there's so many others. Dan McGill was here when I came, but then Manuel Diaz and the championships he's won, Jeff Wallace, Suzanne Yocklin, and go on and on with all of the great championships won by so many great coaches. who was able to attract some incredible student athletes here to the university.
Well, and as you've said, that's what it all comes back to, is the great student athletes. But from an administrative perspective, what was it as an athletic director that you were hoping to provide in terms of an experience, in terms of an education for those student athletes?
Well, we've had some incredible scholar athletes. We've had some great student athletes, but some incredible scholar athletes. So our coaches have just done a wonderful job. We've provided maximum scholarships, provided best facilities, good recruiting budget, and give them an opportunity to do their things, and they did it. They brought great student athletes that help us to win championships.
Well, Coach, as you look at the bigger picture, over 50 years, the amount of opportunities for student athletes, both Georgia football and across the entire athletic department, I think that's a true measure of your legacy in the 50 years here at the University of Georgia.
Well, I'm very proud of that. I'm very proud of our football teams, one that I had an opportunity to coach, but also the coaches that did a terrific job in all the sports to give us, I think, one of the best overall programs in the country.
Well, Coach, this has been a great trip down memory lane. I hope that you've enjoyed it the way that I have and the way that I'm sure our viewers have. 50 years of great stories and great memories, and we're standing here in front of the statue that will keep you immortalized on this campus for centuries to come, and it's just been a thrill to hear about 50 great years, and we're looking forward to many more years of association between you and the university.
Well, I've enjoyed the visit, and it certainly has stirred a lot of great memories for me. Again, it's hard to believe it's been 50 years. This statue, a fellow named Stan Mullins, decided to take a chance and do this, and he had it done, and then it just sat there for, I don't know where it sat, in his studio, I guess, for 4 or 5 years before they finally decided to erect it here. So Stan did a terrific job with him, very proud of it, and particularly proud that they're two players, because that's really what it's all about, are the players, and thanks to them, I was here 50 years.
Well, thank you so much for your time. It is a pleasure to get to talk to you. The legendary Coach Vince Dooley joining us to celebrate 50 years of association between him and the University of Georgia.
I'm going to be inspired by players.
Georgia has the win over 18th ranked LSU.
I'll try to improve from last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
To 2, Tennessee leading, crowd roaring against Georgia, trying to make them drop it. We hand it off to Herschel. There's a hole. 5, 10.
All I remember is hitting his leg, and it was like I hit a tree trunk. It was the hardest thing I've ever hit.
12, he's running over people. Oh, you Herschel Walker. My God almighty, he ran right through two men. Herschel ran right over two men. They had him dead away inside the 9.
Inspired our players.
Georgia has the win over 18th ranked LSU.
I'll try to improve from last year to this year, and we'll see how everything goes.
Dogs on top, 1-0.
To 2, Tennessee leading, crowd roaring against Georgia, trying to make them drop it. We hand it off to Herschel. There's a hole. 5, 10.
All I remember is hitting his leg, and it was like I hit a tree trunk. It was the hardest thing I've ever hit.
12, he's running over people. Oh, you Herschel Walker. My God almighty, he ran right through two men. Herschel ran right over two men. They had him dead away inside the 9.
Inside Georgia Football with Head Coach Mark Richt is presented by Georgia's Own Credit Union. It's your future. Own it. Also brought to you by AT&T, building you a better network. This segment of Inside Georgia Football is brought to you by Hyundai, proud supporter of college football and loyal fans everywhere.
Coach, I know Coach Dooley hired you here.
Coach Dooley did hire me.
You have a lot of respect for him and just in the coaching ranks, the way he was revered.
Right. Well, he did hire me. I was excited to be hired by Coach Dooley. There were some people that actually said, hey, don't go there because Coach Dooley's going to get in your business and all that kind of stuff. And I was like, well, I hope he gets in my business. He's one of the best coaches ever. I would like to have some help the first time I'm head coach, you know. But I will say that I did go to him for advice on a few occasions, and he'd listen and he'd nod his head. And then in the end he'd say, well, it's your team now. You need to decide.
Put it back on you?
Yeah, he did, which was good. And I just appreciate him being there for me. And obviously, again, going back to the hiring, he was part of that group of people that said,
let's take
come
a chance.
On in. Yeah,
let's take a chance on this guy.
That's right.
Had this off week. What do you have an off week like this? What do you try to get accomplished in an off week?
Well, you spend most of your time early on just fundamentally, just getting back to making sure you're blocking well and you're tackling well and you're doing all your special teams work well. There's a technique to everything that we do, and we try to work hard on that. We don't get too crazy on the scheme because we want to take a little time to game plan. We don't want to rush to get it done. But by the end of the week of the open date, we want to have a good bit of the plan in. And then by Monday, everybody can start practicing this scheme and get ahead of the game, so to speak.
Did this open date fall at a good time for you?
Well, I think so. We had one right after game one, and now we have it here, just a little bit past midseason. So I think it was a pretty good timing. And we always want to have an open date prior to an SEC Eastern Division opponent, and we had that in South Carolina, and now we have it, I guess,
for the Florida Gators. Well, Coach, best of luck this coming week. Big week of preparation to all of you in the Bulldog Nation. Thanks for being with us, and don't forget to be back with us next week right here on Inside Georgia Football with Head Coach Mark Rick.